Hello everyone, my name is Anish Rana and today you're watching Kubernetes web series. As of now, we have successfully completed some topics. If you haven't watched those videos, then you may click on the I button. Just for information that this PowerPoint document can be downloaded from my GitHub page. Besides this, subtitle for different languages such as English, French, Russian and German is available for this video. Today we are going to cover one interesting topic, that is how to build Kubernetes cluster. We are talking about how to create Kubernetes cluster. We will cover the theory part first, in which I will try to cover all those commands that I execute on my lab section. I believe that theory part is crucial because we will get to know why we are executing this command. If you want to reach me out, then these are the details you may use. The course outline is how to create the Kubernetes cluster. Before that, we will discuss the prerequisites for this, how to do a smooth installation on CentOS 9 operating system through manual and script. To explain more, we will do manual steps on master nodes and then use script to install the Kubernetes cluster on the worker node. All these steps will be performed on live, it means on the lab. Let's start with the prerequisites first and open the curtain. VM requirement in Kubernetes cluster. First, we need a compatible Linux host machine. Minimum 2 GB RAM. If you allocate less, it will be less room for your application. 2 CPU will be enough. However, if you give more, it would be good. For this cluster, I will assign 20 GB hard disk. Swap must be powered. Swap must be disabled. Full connectivity between your clusters, whether it will be in your public or your private network. Unique hostname, MAC address, and so on. Command to check the requirement. So our next topic is, what are the commands? In order to check the RAM, we need to execute the command cat proc meminfo. However, this command produces too many informations. We are interested only for the memtotal. This command gave us information in KB. In order to change to GB, we need to use awk command and divide it by 1024 two times. If I execute this command, it will tell us 2.16 GB. It means our RAM requirement is fulfilled. Next is CPU. For CPU, again, we can execute cat proc meminfo and grep processor. And if I execute this command, it says that I have two processors, 0 and 1. And our requirement is 2 CPU. It means our requirement is fulfilled. Next is how to disable the swap permanently. We use set command. This command first search the swap keyword. If it find, then it will add the hash in the beginning of the line. It means this line will be comment. You can see here, this is the hash prompt here. Now the question is how to disable the swap for current session. For this, we have a swap of minus a command. In our lab, we will disable the SE Linux because we want to get rid of from the SE Linux context error. So how we can use? We can edit the file SE Linux equal to disable. As of now, we are not using DNS server. Thus, we will use etc host file for the name resolution. For the first time, we will disable the firewall services and then in my coming topics, I will enable the firewall services. Once all the prerequisites fulfilled, then we will install the runtime error. Sorry, a runtime engine. In our case, we will use Docker engine. I have already uploaded Docker videos. If you haven't watched those videos and wish to watch them, then Check the description of this video. I have added the link. Last but not the least, install the Kubernetes packages. That is kubelet, kubeadm, and kubectl. People also call as kubectl for kubectl. In this slide, we have the complete picture. So first, we install the CentOS 9 operating system. On the top of that, we install the Docker engine and then Kubernetes packages. I have already covered the Docker engine, how to install, what are the requirements, my previous videos. So today, we are focused on only on Kubernetes packages. As I said before, Kubernetes packages, we need to install three packages: kubelet, kubeadm, and kubectl. Let's have a look into these packages. First one in kubelet. Again, kubelet is already described in my previous video, but for this video, I have just added all the line here. So kubelet is an agent which run on each node, worker nodes and master nodes. Primary use is to register the node with the API server. Kubelet interact with both the container runtime, pod main, and the node. It create, run, destroy pod on the worker node based on the pod specs YAML file received from the API server. Report the status of the pod and nodes to the API server. As I said previously, I have already covered this topic in my previous video. You will observe the link in the description. Kubeadm. When we install the kubeadm package, it will provide us the kubeadm command. Kubeadm is a command tool used to build Kubernetes cluster. Kubeadm performs the necessary action to get a minimum viable cluster up and running quickly. Kubectl. Kubectl is the Kubernetes specific command line tool that let you communicate and control Kubernetes cluster with the help of this command. You can create, manage, or delete the resources of your Kubernetes clusters. So let's jump into our lab section. Let me log in into this master VM. The username is Arana. Password is Red Hat. To root user. Check the date, 14 November, 6:20 p.m. That's great. My NTP is synchronized. The very first one is to check the RAM. If I execute this command, it will see, you can see here, 2.16 GB RAM, which is more than recommended. Next is check the CPU, and I have two CPU. That's again good. etc fs tab. As you can see here, that the swap is enabled. I have one command that is set minus I. It will insert and check the swap and insert this. And let me check this file again. As you can see here at the bottom, swap, as you can see here, this hash is added here. Now we can disable this swap in the current session. For the current session, swap off. Okay. After that, we were talking about SC Linux disable. It says that it is enforcing and I need to convert it to disable. Again, here I'm using set minus I option and this hyphen hyphen follow symbolic links, and it is disabled. Set enforce 0 for the current session. As you may aware that we are not using DNS server, but for that reason I am adding the file IP address of my worker node 1 and 2 in my etc host file. This is my etc host file. Now let me ping my worker node 1 and it should pingable by my name. I use minus c 2 minus c stand for count. Clear the screen, press 2 times enter, and then again it is working fine. This is the first time we are installing the Kubernetes cluster. For that reason, I'm just stop the firewall service and then disable. It should not up after reboot. Now let me check systemctl status of firewall service, and it is showing inactive. Let me clear the screen here. Mode probe br net filter, I need to enable it. Now I can check if it's enabled or not. Ls mode list module and IP tables, we need to enable the bridge networking here. Now you can check here, this is the command systemctl minus a and then grep netbridge. It says equal to 1. Equal to 1 means it is enabled, and if it shows equal to 0, it means it is disabled. It's time to install the Docker packages as a runtime engine. First, I'm going to remove the existing one. I used minus y for that reason, it is not asking me to press. As you can see here, that only one package is removed, that is build ah. It's time to install the yumutil command and then add the Docker package. I hope we will not observe any issue because I did this installation 4 and 5 times before. Now I'm adding the repo file. It's time to install the runtime engine Docker. As we have installed the Docker and Docker used Docker daemon, right? But for Kubernetes, it is used C group. For that reason, I'm just adding this command containerd config default, and it will see, all the parameters here, right? So let me grab here system group, and you will say it is false. So in this file, I'm going to add here that it is true, so that when I install the Kubernetes init package, it will not give me an error. So again, for any changes, I'm using my side command. So it will change from false to true. So it means that my containerd will use the system group C group. C group means control group. Now if I check here, you can see here it is still showing false. Why? I executed the right command. Okay, exit this one. Okay, so I just executed the previous command, so this is the reason. By default, it is all the default options are insert in this file here. It should show me true value here. So let's start the Docker service and then enable it. And it's time to check the Docker package if it's working fine or not. So a simple command is docker run hello world. Image is not found locally. It go to the internet and pull the image. Hello from Docker. This message shows your installation appear to be working correctly. Perfectly fine. Now it's time to install the Kubernetes packages. Before installing the packages, let me add the repo file for the Kubernetes. So this is the file. repo file I have added here and install the three services. Let me clear the screen here. Kubelet, kubeadm, and kubectl, and install these packages. I have already covered all these three packages in my theory part. So we have successfully download the packages and install it. It's time to enable the kubelet service and then start enable and then start kubelet. Kubelet is very important. And if I go up, I executed, I will check at the end how much time it will take complete installation. Okay. So power off, I have already executed this command here. So it's time to install the kubeadm init. Kubeadm init. First is checking the prerequisites. The flight. If RAM is 2 GB, CPU is 2 GB, hostname is unique, MAC address is unique. All these information it is checked by the kubeinit command internally. If you are using the DNS server, you will not see this type of warning. So it's warning, it's okay. As of now, I don't have any error message. That's good. The next step of kubeadm would be to create the CA server. CA means Certificate Authority Server. It will issue the token and check the PKI. CA certificate and A and key, it is adding. And then it will go to etc Kubernetes manifest file and then create all the clusters, then create all the static ports of API, controller, scheduler, and etcd on the base of token, where it get the token from the CA server. All these functionality is being done by kubeadm packages. Using manifest folder, it is go to this directory here. And then static port, creating static port. It is very important in the point of troubleshooting and interview purpose. People will ask, do API server are the static port or the dynamic port? So as you can see here that my init command successfully completed. And it says that to start using your cluster, you need to run the following as a regular user. So what I do, I just copy these three commands and right click here. And now I'm going to save this line as a token here. I need to add from the worker node, I need to execute this command. In this command, it says that kubeadm join 131 is the IP address of this machine of master. The port number is 6443, the API server use 6443, and the token is this, and discovery token is this. So if it receives the information from the client side, it will accept it. So let me save this, and if I execute my command kubectl get nodes, I will see that my node is not ready. Why? Because I have not added the network. For that reason, there are different type of network available in the Kubernetes. Okay, so let me check here. Kubernetes port networking. So once I click here, I'm just click on the first one, cluster networking Kubernetes. And if I go down, see this page for non-exhaustive list of networking. Here you will see different type of services are network policies are there. ACI, Antera, Calcico, Channel. There are different type of networking here, right? So I'm using Calcico. You apply minus F. Okay, so let me check here. Kubectl get nodes, and if I press here, it is showing not ready. It takes some time, don't worry. it will be up. Okay, so let me check this again. As you can see here that now it is ready. So we did the installation of Kubernetes cluster, initialize the cluster in the master node. Let me tell you one thing here, and if I execute here, kubectl get pod, if I press enter, it will show you nothing. But when you say minus a is for all namespace, I will let you know in some other session what is the meaning of namespace here. And you can see here that namespace kube system, and you see Calcico node. So these are the ports running: scheduler, proxy, controller, API server, and etcd master one server. So these are the four components here, master components. Can we create pod here? How to create a pod? I'm just telling you here, just cat one and pod one dot YAML. If you're not aware about YAML, I will come up with the one session for the YAML. What is YAML? For that, for now, you can just think about it. There is one extension here, and how to apply kubectl create minus f and then file name here. I hit the enter, and now the pod will be up and running, but this will be not the case. Why? If I use, and I have, as you can see here, that I'm not using any namespace here. So whenever you are not using any namespace, your pod will be create on default namespace. Kubectl get pod. You say, you can see here that it is showing pending. It will be pending forever. The reason behind is that when you see nodes, and this is the name of my node, right? And it is in ready status. Kubectl describe reptaint have resources master one. Okay, node here. You can see here that it is showing no schedule. Okay, so I need to remove the no schedule taint, then only this pod will work here. But I'm not going to spawn this pod here. So how to delete this pod here? Kubectl delete minus f and then pod here. I'm going to delete this pod here. Although it is not working, I'll just show you that why it is not working here. So there is a one term taint. I will explain in. So I will explain in my later slide that what is taint and how we can use this thing. Don't worry. So now we have successfully installed the kubeadm, initialize our cluster through manual step. Now it's time to create the script, and this time we are going to install all these packages through script here. Okay, let me create one file here, .sh and shift. So these are the commands. Let me go down, shift E, and delete three things. Okay, so this is the token. chmod 775 and giving the privileges, and then script is executing here. Now, as you can see here, that it is saying that RAM is 2 GB, more than 2 GB, CPU is 2. That is recommended. Checking worker node 2 and master node 1. Let me execute the same command on, not command but script, on worker node 2 also. New session. clear the window, chmode, change mode 775, and then script, and then date command. It will execute at the end date command. We'll get to know that how much time it take in the cluster. Now, as you can see here, that my one pod is ready and the other node is waiting, not ready. It is pending state. However, the script is working fine. I'm just sharing the script with you, and also I will share the script on my GitHub page. You need to just change the IP address of your node. So here I'm using 192.168.1.31.32 and 33. You just need to change with your IP address, and at the end you need to add the kubeadm join command token output. So now, as you can see here, that both my worker node 1 and 2 are the part of my Kubernetes cluster. So now the next step is to install the bash autocomplete. This step is also very important to avoid the typo error. So now I'm going to install the bash completion package. I'm not sure whether this package is installed already or not. I'm just using yum. Yes, this is already installed. Let me source this file, and after that echo all this to bash rc, to completion bash rc here, and then kubectl. Yes. If you execute these four commands, you will observe that kubectl, and if I press tab, it will autocomplete to T. Now I can create the pod with the help of YAML file. Thanks to Kubernetes for providing such a good document here. And if I use this here, pod dot YAML, and then clear the screen, kubectl create is a command minus f pod dot YAML. If I execute this command here, and what is the outcome here? To get pod. So I can use pod or po. Kubernetes is very intelligent and it understand our intention, and it says that Nginx pod is running. I hope you will get to know that how to install the Kubernetes cluster and how to create the cluster and adding worker node to master nodes with the help of manual command or through the scripts. Thank you very much, guys. Bye bye.